You don't have anything. Without further ado, let's get this party started. So let's go back a little bit. So we already gave you the six symptoms of systemic racism. And let's go ahead and take a little history lesson. Let's go back and see from the very beginning of how the past is dictating what's going on now in the present.
So what caused these six examples of systemic racism? The momentum of history. In the early years of the United States, millions of African Americans were enslaved. Even those who were, quote, free, were heavily discriminated against. Many forget that Europeans initially enslaved Native Americans. At least hundreds of thousands were driven off their lands. Tens of thousands died in wars and massacres. After slavery ended, governments across the country passed laws that treated African Americans as second-class citizens, stripping them of the same opportunities others had. Meanwhile, the United States government forced Native Americans onto mainly communal reservations. Individuals rarely had property rights. They couldn't own land. This eventually made it difficult for them to establish credit and borrow money. While the Dawes Act of 1887 let most Native Americans own property, it also gave away nearly two-thirds of all Native American land. Holy crap! And allowed rich developers to buy most of the most productive land. Not only that, developers often tricked many Native Americans into selling their land, leaving many of them homeless. The Dawes Act also caused many tribes to lose their culture by shipping their children to boarding schools. Oh, and Native Americans couldn't vote. Even after the passage of the Indian Citizenship Act of 1924, whites prevented Native Americans from voting in other sneaky ways. African Americans could vote, but they often first had to jump through some hoops to do so. They had to pay poll taxes, take ridiculously difficult tests, or face intimidation from white supremacist groups like the Ku Klux Klan. Because of this, no African Americans served in Congress between the years 1901 to 1928, despite being between 10 to 12% of the total population at the time. That was also the time when the majority of Confederate statues went up, by the way. A pretty horrific time to be a person of color in America. And that's also when racial violence peaked. Race riots, most infamously the Tulsa Race Massacre. Thousands of African Americans got lynched. Typically how it went down was something bad would happen to a white person. A black person, usually a black man, would get blamed. A mob would kidnap the person blamed. And finally, publicly execute them. If you never learned any of this in school, this is the part of the video where you probably just need to stop and ask yourself, why?
Hey, Tracy.
Hello, Tracy. Let me address that very last part, what he was talking about. This also goes with why I don't comment back to the people that makes comments on our videos. You was never taught these things. And even if you were taught a few of these things, you dismissed it as either unfounded or flat out untrue. We're talking about a group of European people who went to another person's land and either tricked them into selling it, stole it, or killed them for it. Then went to another country, grabbed those people to come and physically, or intimidation, or whatever you have it, work on this stolen land to build up their wealth. After that, once these people who were stolen or threatened to come to the land was freed, you treat them second class. You didn't keep a promise to 40 acres and a mule. You, I'm so dumbfounded that this history is something that people can look back on and with a straight face say, no, it's not true. And if it is true, you never lived through it. I'm sorry that I have empathy for my people. You didn't live through Christopher Columbus, but you still celebrate Christopher Columbus. So I'm just dumbfounded by some of the comments, and not dumbfounded as being mad, dumbfounded as I just can't believe your intelligence or lack thereof.